students. Today I do nationalism in Europe, just one part of it, which I personally feel is a little difficult because the words, the places are a little unfamiliar to us. So let's try and do this answer. The question is that if you see the mid 18th century map of Europe, you will find no nation states as you see them today. So the mid 18th century map of Europe, very different from what it is today. Now we come to the answer. I have tried to divide it into introduction. Then you have your main body of the answer, which again I've split into A and B. And last is the conclusion. And I always feel conclusions are important to complete the answer. So now we start that today what you know as Germany, Italy and Switzerland were earlier divided into kingdoms, duchies and cantons. So these three places earlier were divided into kingdoms, duchies and cantons. And they were ruled by rulers who had control over autonomous territories. Autonomous territories means independent territories. So their rulers ruled over autonomous territories. Now we take this part, East and Central Europe. East and Central Europe was under autocratic monarchies. Autocratic is very despotic, very authoritative, who suppress the people, don't give them freedoms. So East and Central Europe was under autocratic monarchies. And very diverse people lived over here. Different types of people who felt that they did not share a common identity and culture. They didn't feel that sense of oneness. They felt they were different. They spoke different languages. They belonged to different ethnic groups. So this, students, would be your introduction. Now I come to the main body of the answer, which I've split into A and B, as I told you all. A is aristocrats and B is peasants. So the main thing is, we speak about the Habsburg Empire. That was a very, very powerful empire of Europe. So the Habsburg Empire ruled over which place? Austria-Hungary. Habsburg Empire ruled over Austria-Hungary. It was a patchwork of different regions and people. It was not one consolidated territory. Different people, different regions it was. Now we speak of the aristocrats only. Now this Austria-Hungary included which places? There are four. First is Alpine regions. The Alpine region included Tyrol, Austria and southern Finland. Now for your information, Tyrol is a chain of hills. Today it could cover, you could say, France, Switzerland, Italy, these places. So included the Alpine region of Tyrol, Austria and southern Finland. Which language did the aristocrats speak? They spoke German. Now come to the language Italian. Italian speaking provinces were in Lombardy and Venetia. Now come to this place, Hungary. Half the population spoke Magyar, half spoke different dialects. Galicia. For your information again, Galicia today, half of it is in Poland and half of it is in Ukraine. Here the aristocrats spoke Polish. So this Austria-Hungary included 1, 2, 3, 4 places, and which languages the aristocrats spoke. Now come to the B part, that is peasants. Now within this empire, there lived many peasants too. Now how will you learn them? The Bohemians and Slovaks to the north, Slovenes in Carniola, Croats to the south, and Romans to the east in Transylvania. So you have your north, south and east, just remember it that way. And then, so Bohemians, Slovaks north, Croats south, Romans you have east in Transylvania and Slovenes in Carniola. Now you come to your conclusion. So much of diversity, so much of differences. So naturally, political unity was not promoted. No political unity amongst them. But then to these diverse group of people, they had one link which tied them together. And what was that link? It was their common allegiance to the emperor. Allegiance means loyalty, support. It was their common allegiance, loyalty to the emperor. So this is your 5-mark or 3-mark answer for this question. And I hope it's become a little easier for you all now. So happy learning. Thank you.